So guys, in this video we are going to see the exception handling in Python. So there are some few exceptions you need to handle. Suppose say division by zero. So let's go ahead and say temp is equals to 3 2 divided by zero. So now let's execute this one. So it says zero division error, division by zero. So now let's say print of hi. So you can see we got the zero division error and this print statement did not execute. So whenever there is an exception in Python or in any language, the program stops at that point. So you need to handle that exception and pass through that exception to execute your own code. So what you're gonna do is you want to say try and you need to put the indentation. We did this one and try, let's say temp is equals to 2 by 0. So whenever there is a exception and you need to catch that using this except. So except, you need to specify the error or the exception you want to encounter, that is zero division error. As you can see, the already Visual Studio Code suggesting me zero division error. And I can put the semicolon and I can print. So zero division error has been occurred. I can say just divide by zero is not possible. So now let's go ahead and run the script. Sorry. And I can see my output has been printed because the script does not stop there only. Then you can see the print statement. Now I can also say I can write my code in this except block, but you can write the code in the other block as well. So let's just before going to writing other code, you need to say as e. So you can also catch this exception as an object and you can just say print of e dot underscore underscore class. So it will print out the what type of error we have got, zero division error. So you can also say catch except exception. So this will catch all the exceptions and it will print what type of exception you have got. You can see we have got the zero division error. You don't need to mention any of these also. This is like blindly catching every other exception. You can just say pass here. So this is how you handle the errors using the try except block. So if there is no error in this try block and you want to execute some of the code, you can put the else block. So you want to try this code and there are any exceptions, you are going to this except block, else you want to go to this block. Let's say print of temp and you can set 2 to. So now if I run this script, we got the one. So we have executed some other block instead of this exception. We have successfully overcome this exception. And there is another thing finally, and this block will execute however if you got any exception or not. So this is like a destructor in any other. So I should not call it a destructor, but it's doing the thing. It will run after all the Python code. So it will run as a final block. And if I run this, no matter what, if I got exception or not, this final block gets executed. You can see I'm gonna execute here. Now let's change it to zero. Now we will get the exception. And how we found that we got exception, because this block is not executed, that's because we got the exception and we just passed over it and the finally block has been executed. So this finally block is used to release some resources. Suppose in try block, if you open a file and you can close this in here, so to make sure that all the resources are closed efficiently. So that's all the basics about this exception handling, try, except and else and finally. So in our, it's just a easy way to catch all the exceptions and pass through this, so we do not deal with any other exceptions as well. So these are all about the basics of the exception handling. I hope you have understood.